Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1736, Hide Blank Rows Without a Macro. Today's question sent in by Kathy. Someone just asked whether there's a way to alter a row's height. Actually, they want to hide the row completely without doing it in the context of a macro. Is there a formula that would, you know, set the parameters of a row? So I have a mock-up here of Kathy's workbook. I changed the actual data, but they have this list. And for any items that are not filled in this box, they want to hide those rows. And my initial reaction was, well, hey, maybe we could do this with conditional formatting. Alt-O-D would create a new rule, use a formula to determine which cells to format, and then when you know we wanted to hide it, I would change the font size back to 1. But that's kind of grayed out. We're not allowed to choose from that list, so that is not going to work, the conditional formatting. Boy, this would be really easy with a macro. All right, so the other thing I thought was maybe we could come out here outside of the print range, and we could create an auto filter range. All right, so I'll hide this row is the heading. And we could build any kind of a formula here. Now here, my formula is actually easy. It's going to be equal is blank of this cell over here. But this formula can be as complex as you can imagine. And actually, I noticed on Kathy's workbook, there was a statistic here that we never wanted to hide that particular row. So even if that was blank, we needed to show this revenue total here or something. So you could modify that formula so that way, you know, if column E wasn't blank, then it would, you know, wouldn't be true or something like that. All right, so we have this section out here. It's outside of the context of the print range, so no one will see it. You know, if you wanted to, you can even put it out in column Z where it won't show up on the screen, and we'll apply a filter and say hide this row. We want to unhide the trues. Click OK. All right, now here's the beautiful thing about this. So let's say that one of these items gets cleared and we delete it. Click delete. Well, it doesn't disappear automatically, but all we would have to do is come back to the data tab and click the reapply button. See, now I'm not even in the auto filtered area. I don't have to select one of those cells. Since there can only be one auto filter per worksheet, it's obvious to Excel what we're trying to do. And when I click reapply, that gets hidden. Cool, right? No macros seems to work. But you know, the big problem is, what if they had to add something? Now all of the blanks are hidden. So I guess you'd have to come out here to data and then clear the filter to get everything back. To make that simpler, it might have been good to go to View, Custom Views, and create a new view called Show All. Click OK, and then apply the filter, hiding the trues. And now Custom Views will create a new view, add, called Hide Blanks. Click OK, and then it would be a matter of Custom Views. We could double click on Show All to get them back. We could edit something, and then Custom Views, go back to Hide Blanks, and it would hide on the fly. So again, not a macro method. Boy, this would have been so much easier with a macro, but I think using the auto filter outside of the print range is one way to do this without a macro. All right, well, I want to thank Kathy for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.